welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Army is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. He's to the 20. He's out to the 30. Across midfield. He's knocked out of bounds at the 44-yard line. So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
He's at the 30, he's at the 20, and he's taken down at the 16.
That's a very nice, relaxed delivery right there. Even in the face of the blitz, he held his ground and made a perfect toss. That's a big boost.
Tackle around the 8-yard line.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
It's 3rd down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. He's taken down at the 9.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
Akron could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, and it sails through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Taken at the 5. And he's taken down at the 28. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. And they'll get him in the backfield. From their own 26-yard line, 2nd down. They get it out there on the toss. He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
Knocked out of bounds at the 40. Well, the last drive was good for 3, but I'm sure in this one they'll be looking to double that. Akron holds a field goal lead. Quick pass, and they make the stop at the 46-yard line.
He had a couple of freight trains coming at him, but when they blitzed, it created a hole in the coverage, and they took advantage of it.
Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away.
You know, nothing makes a defensive coordinator happier than seeing a corner make a play like that. Great technique. He's in position. He knocked that football away. And it's almost as if he's closing one side of the field down for this defense.
Zips it to the back. They'll bring him down at about the 31. That one goes for good yardage and a 1st down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on 2nd down.
Throws complete. He's hit right away.
makes it second and six. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown! Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's a five-play, 60-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
He'll return it from the one. Gets out to about the 21. It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. They'll knock him down for a loss. They don't get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper, a loss of one. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball in their own 20. And down he goes at the 30.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. He makes it to the 48-yard line. The Zips are having a ton of fun down there on the sidelines. You can just see that everything's clicking for them. It's looking easy.
Now, remember, it's still early in this football game, and if I'm the defense on the other side of the football, I'm trying to come up with ways when we're on the sideline of what we can do to stop this powerful offense.
This one will fall incomplete. Second and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. It to the halfback on the screen. Tackle made at the 47-yard line. Straight run, and he's brought down in the backfield.
Sometimes when you think you've got great plays called, the defense just has the answers.
Certainly, they don't have the return on here. He's taken down at the 18. Akron's defense is playing lights out right now and pitching a shot.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. I just the way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, there's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
Tackled at the 29-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Gets out to about the 31. There was some movement on the line.
Offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a five-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
So it's second and 14. Ball on their own 26. On the
pitch. Look out. Loose ball. The defense falls on it. Kirk, what happened on the option play there?
Well, you got to give credit to the defense. They knew what was coming, and they came up and made the play.
They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. There's a strike complete. Touchdown, Zips. And he tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Zips are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
Gets to about the 27-yard line. He plows ahead for a 2-yard gain. Tackled around the 25-yard line. It's third down and 10. Ball on the 25. Things starting to get out of hand here as we head to the second quarter. 17 to nothing. Zips. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter.
Let's go one more. Let's go.
Passes, and it's almost picked off.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
He makes it to the 45-yard line. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Under heavy pressure. He's wrapped up for the sack.
That'll bring up third and long.
So the sack makes this third and very long. Here comes the pressure, and he's going to come up with a sack.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Calls for the fair catch.
Brad, as good as this defense has looked, I'm not necessarily surprised by this shutout. I mean, you and I were there on Wednesday watching this team practice, and when this first-team defense goes against their own first-team offense in a practice, sometimes it's actually better than the game itself. So They've prepared themselves very well to have this kind of game.
He gets out to about the 35-yard line.
That's a gain of two. That makes it second and eight.
Tackled for a loss.
The option can be really tough to defend. At that time, it was well played by the defense.
That brings us third and 12.
We've got third and 12. Ball on their own 31. Fires to his fullback, no good.
Number 26 is the intended receiver on the ball. That makes it fourth and 12.
The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. Tackle made at the 36. The Zips came out of the blocks, and they were on fire, but they've really slowed down here.
Yeah, give credit to the defense that they're facing. Early in the game, as you said, it seems like this offense couldn't do anything wrong. But the last few series, this defense has done a much better job of controlling their big play ability.
Set. Blue 14.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And he's taken down at the 46. And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He steps out around the 49-yard line.
That makes it 37.
Slings it.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Gets it out quickly. And he tackles him hard at the 34-yard line.
Called a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Hey, check back six.
Fires quick. He's got another one. Tackle at the 30-yard line.
16 makes the tackle. That's a gain of 4. That'll make it third and one.
Makes it out to about the 19.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Hey, check back six.
He might have a chance. Gains his way to the 10-yard line. Akron just took their first time out. This is the ninth play of this drive. Taken down around the 4-yard line. Gain of 6 on the pass, and that's good for a first down.
Heads up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. Guns it in there. Touchdown. Nicely.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
He makes the PAT. So a 10-play, 67-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. From the 5-yard line, he's out to the 30. He's tackled at the 33. It's still only the second quarter.
We got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. And he hits him hard at the 49-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
He's going to try and scramble, and they make the stop at about the 49. And he didn't get much on that scramble before they drilled him.
Brad, that's a great way for the quarterback to get himself injured. He needs to be a lot more careful out there.
He scrambles. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Slides down to the ground. The grab past the marker. They'll bring him down right around the 34. And it looks like there's an injury down there on the field. From the 34-yard line, it's first down. Slings it out there incomplete. Him down in the backfield. That's a loss of about five.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Quick throw, and down he goes, right around the 16-yard line. Flushed and they got him. Now he tries to buy some time. Brought down at the 20-yard line. He throws. Puts it right in his hands. Touchdown. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes. So kudos to the quarterback. So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the two-point conversion. And the goal line defense digging in here. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
False start. Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
They'll go for two in this situation.
The Black Knights wideout out with an apparent injury, although he might make a comeback before this game's over.
They don't get it.
A 10-play, 67-yard drive, but they just get 6 points after failing to convert for two.
Army is ready to kick it away. Taken from the 3-yard line. Knocked out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. Akron's done what they had to do offensively. They've done a nice job here in the first half, partner.
Boy, it's been very consistent for them, and consequently, they have a nice lead here going into halftime. But again, they've got to be able to do a nice job here of continuing to fight, because this offense that they're facing across the line of scrimmage on the other side of the ball, they can score in a hurry. So still a lot of football to be played.
And they hit him in the backfield. Second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. First half comes to a close as they head to the locker rooms. 24-6, zip.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Steve Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This halftime lead can make a team feel as if the game is over, that they've already done their work, that they put the other guy away. but I think the first few minutes of the second half could be paramount if they want to build on this lead and make sure that they finish it with a victory.
Well, absolutely. If you come out and you give up a score right away, you're talking about making this game within two scores and making it a little bit closer than you want it to. So if you can come out, get a stop, get a score, you can put this game out of reach right away. You can make the other side extremely one-dimensional, make them pass happy, and put them in a situation where you know exactly what you're going to get from them. So you got to come out in the first few minutes of the third quarter, establish yourself, and shut that door of any hope for the other side.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
Number 13, defensive return.
He's to the 20. Brought down at the 29.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Bring him down for a loss on the play.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on their own 28. Tackle made at the 27-yard line.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really, nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
And he shoved out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. And that was a really well-played series by the defense. This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. We're about set to start things up again.
Here we go.
Hey, check back six.
He passes it. And it's picked off.
Hey, this could potentially turn this football game around. They're down by a couple scores, but if you're the offense and you're on the sideline and you're not feeling good about yourself and your defense comes up with an interception like that, boy, oh, boy, you're grabbing your helmet, sprinting on that field, and you're ready to go.
And he's tackled right around the 46-yard line. To about the 44-yard line. He's tackled at the 30.
To run all the way. He got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
It's second down now. 13 to go. Ball on the 33. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's taken down at the 31-yard line. Looking for six. Almost intercepted.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And he might want it all here, and does. Great coverage, and it's intercepted.
That was perfect coverage against a pretty good route. He was all over that pass.
Nearly intercepted.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. Tackle at about the 27-yard line.
Complete. He's got room to work. That's a great tackle at the 33-yard line.
Well, on third down, we expected them to go to the air, and they did just that, picking up the first down.
He makes it to the 35-yard line.
Incomplete. He was looking for the tight end.
Number 18, the intended receiver.
And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. Stepping up. Fires out to his receiver. There's a very impressive open field tackle. It's the ninth play of the drive.
That makes it second and 10.
He's taken down around the 31-yard line. Level at the 27. He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
He goes out of bounds at the 26-yard line. To his receiver, and they make the stop around the 19-yard line.
First down.
And this is the 13th play of this drive. Just throws this one away. From the 19-yard line. Second down. The Zips wide receiver, we hope, can make a comeback and get back in this ball game. Went out with that injury a little bit earlier. Quick throw out to the receiver. Big play, and it's first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Zips.
Vision here by the quarterback and a good understanding of where he was on the field. He didn't need much, and he knew he could get it himself.
And he hits the PAT. Akron kicked this one off. And that's not the type of quality kickoff we're used to seeing from this kid.
Free kick out of bounds.
Oh, man, did he shank that one? You can't go giving away great field position like that.
They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Throws it out right to the running back. He gets hit out of bounds. around the 43-yard line.
They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Quick throw, and he's got the halfback again. And he tackles him hard at the 48. Now he's scrambling. They'll bring him down at the 41. Open field. Excellent open field tackle. And down he goes at the 22-yard line. There's a strike complete. Brought down at the 21-yard line. And it looks like they're going to run away with this one as we head into the fourth quarter. The Zips are up big. Not sure there's any hope for a comeback here in the fourth quarter, but Kirk and I are praying. Makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
A conversion there could have really helped them, but it just wasn't to be. They punched it in for six on the last series. Can they do it again?
I expect them to run the ball, kill the clock, and put this one in the books.
Akron with a commanding lead. Makes it to the 27. First and 10. Ball on their own 27. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle made around the 33-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
Quick strike to the receiver, and he's tackled at about the 39-yard line. From their own 39-yard line, first down. Zips it to the back. He's gobbled up in the backfield. Fights forward to about the 40.
Gain of three on the play. That'll make it third and nine.
Here's third and nine. Ball on the 40. gets hit before he can go anywhere. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. From the 15, sheds that one, and he just got stood up right there. Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Receiving team.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. From their own 10-yard line, first down. He's tackled at the 19-yard line. And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Hits him hard at the 32. Army will take their first time out of the half. It's first and 10. Ball on the 32. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. About 2 yards there on the fullback draw. The Black Knights are going to call their second timeout. We have less than a minute to go. Out of bounds, right around the 32-yard line.
That brings us third and 10.
From their own 32-yard line, third down. Stop made there late in the fourth quarter, but this game's been over almost since the beginning. I think it's time for everybody to head to the locker room.
That'll make it fourth and six.
Tackle made at the 31. We're late in the fourth quarter. This game has been a blowout for quite some time, and Kirk and I are just looking to make our flights. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. And this one's all but wrapped up. The Zips take this one, 31-6. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.